It's time now for Reporters Roundtable to put the headlines in perspective. Bud and Ross both still with us. And Ross, we'll start with you. You know, right up until filing day, Texas Democrats were still filing to run for governor. What message does that send that it took them so long?
Well, I think it ultimately doesn't matter. If they have enough time to get in front of voters between now and March 6th, they'll be okay. The problem here is that other than Lupe Valdez, none of these people has been on a ballot before. They've got a lot of work to do, a lot of voters to talk to before the voting begins.
That's a good point, Bud.
Jason, you know, a lot of talk about Lupe, but, you know, Lupe has a voter base in Dallas. She's from San Antonio. She announced in Austin. The question is whether she'll be able to win any other counties.
Ross, there's been a lot of talk about Texas A&M just hiring out a new football coach, paying $75 million. How's that going to play with lawmakers in Austin?
I think it's going to depend on how many games Texas A&M win between now and the beginning of the legislative session in January 2019. It's actually more money than that. They paid $10.5 million to pay off Kevin Sumlin, the former coach. You know, it's a lot of money to put on the line. It's a lot of explaining to do if they have a lousy football team next year.
You know, the Aggies have a game this week, so do the Longhorns, so do the Houston Cougars. We can see who's getting the most money out of their coach. But the A&M will tell you they make more money off their football program than they're paying the coach. I think that'll be tested.
Yeah, but this is a state university, Bud. I mean, people are going to cry foul over this, especially the non-A&M fans.
I think the people, all the people in Austin for the last 10 years who've been saying UT spends too much and wastes too much have to look at their own Aggies now.
Good point. You know, Ross, with Christmas here just hours away, right around the corner, what can Santa leave for state lawmakers or for folks up here in Dallas, Fort Worth, North Texas, or down in Austin? What are they looking for? What's on their Christmas wish list?
Well, I think the Republicans are hoping that they don't get a Trump wave in 2018, and I think that's the first thing on their Christmas wish list. The Democrats are hoping that there is a Trump wave and that there's some way for the Democrats to break through, and I think that'd probably be the top of their list.
Trump wave is what everyone's praying for, I guess, or non-Trump wave, too, huh?
But, in Dallas-Fort Worth, I think they're looking for a word from Amazon and maybe an Amazon headquarters here and see what Amazon will bring. And bring 50,000 workers, but not all Democrats, so that they don't turn the Metroplex too purple too fast.
Have we heard when that's going to be announced, Bud?
I don't think we've heard. They're in the second round now, so we'll see, you know, how much of a say-so Dallas-Fort Worth has. You know, and something else that Santa could bring would be a better transit system. You know, we have DART, serves part of the Metroplex, but not all. You know, some of the areas that are the most practical for Amazon also have the least transportation.
And good point, too. It looks like the bullet train, Ross and Bud, survived the last legislative sessions. There's probably no stopping it now, so that could be on the tracks to finality, huh?
The train will be pulling in the back of Channel 8 pretty soon, I think.
Not long at all. Gentlemen, thank you guys very much, and Merry Christmas to you. We appreciate it. Thank you for watching as well. Hope you and your family have a Merry Christmas, and we'll see you again next Sunday.